everybody. Welcome to my channel. This is the first in a long series of, hopefully, reviews of in-game equipment and also modifications. Today I chose to start with the Krone BiG X 1100. This is one of the most misunderstood pieces of equipment in the game. I think part of the issue is, one, this game does not have a whole lot of information in it to begin with. So, you know, you go into the store and it says, Harverster. And it shows you a little symbol of like something that doesn't look like any of the other harvesters have. And it's like, okay, well, I guess it's a harvester. And then so people buy it. And, you know, I tell you what, I just yesterday I saw a post on the forum. I hate this thing. It's a piece of crap. I wish I wouldn't have wasted my money on it. Well, you have to understand what this is. And we're going to get into that. This is not really a harvester, okay? It does not have a collection tray like the other harvesters or chamber. But it does harvest in a sense. Really what this is a gigantic, I guess, mower, you could say, but it's not even that because it's different. What this particular device or piece of equipment is looking for, it wants to grab the husks or what they call the chaff off of your seeds. Now, grass, wheat, corn, barley, all of those quote-unquote fruits have a seed shell, okay? So there's a casing that goes around the shell. That is called the chaff. Now, my friend across the street, he makes coffee. He buys coffee from Colombia and from Ecuador and from Guatemala, and he gets a 5-pound bag, and they come here green, okay? The beans are green. He puts them in his roaster and roasts them. As they roast, their husk falls off, or the chaff, and it fills up the clean. He's always vacuuming out all this chaff. It's like a leftover piece of garbage that you don't want. Except for one thing. In this game, the number one way to make money, and I'm prove this to you. See this right here? This is the biogas plant. The next closest thing is going to be wood chips at $2,000. So almost $1,000 less per ton. So what is silage? If you guys don't know, I have a tutorial on making silage, okay? You check that out, first of all. But what the silage is basically it's rotted or fermented grass or chaff, okay? So let's go. We're going to run down. I'm going to show you the silo so you can see what it looks like. There are two places in this game where silage goes. The first is to the cow pasture. You put the silage in, you ferment it, and then the cows eat it. They love it, and it helps them produce milk. The other place you go is here at the biogas plant. You can see here, this is silage. It's ready to go. All I have to do is unload this into those Flegel bins. Excuse me, over there. Let's go over and take a look. These are the loading bins for the silage. So what happens, the process is this. You mow the grass, or you use your Krone BiG X to gather chaff, or those husks, and you bring the husks down here and you dump them off in one of these bins, okay? When the bin is full enough, it'll tell you, it'll say you can cover it. There's over here on the help menu up in the top left hand side, you'll get a little message saying that it's full enough to cover. Maybe like 20%, or I think 12% is the minimum amount that you have to have in here to cover it. Well, you're going to cover it, and over maybe the next 7 or 8 hours, it's going to ferment. When it comes down here, it's real green, okay? When it's done fermenting, the silo blanket will disappear, and you'll have this. And then you take this product, and you can either use a bucket loader, or you can download a conveyor belt mod, and you can dump this silage into the bins over here. So that's how that works. Once again, the other place you're going to use it is with your cows, and we'll run over there. I got to tell you, while we're driving over, I just want to share this with you. On patch 1.2, and that I got to go back because I'm realizing I need to show you, they broke two of the silos. They can only be used once. So this first silo here that's full and the second silo here are broken. You can fill them up once, but you can never empty them all the way. So once you've used these two silos once, you're done using them until they fix that. I'm sure they will fix that at some time, or somebody will come up with a hack or a workaround in the XML files to fix this, but right now these are broken. These two work, so you can go ahead and I would just use these two silos for now until They fixed that. So we're talking patch 1.2. Those first two silos are broken. So I wanted to share that with you because that's something that will probably change, but at least for right now, that's where we're at. So over here is where the cow silo is on this map. I don't know if they're broken on, I haven't seen anybody saying that they're broken on the other map on Bjornholm, but on this one they are broken. So here is the silage for the cows. And you mix it with hay and grass and you feed it to them and they love it and then they produce lots of milk. And I've got 100 cows and they produce about $100,000 a day. So it's worthwhile. So that's silage and that's why you need it. So that's what the Krone BiG X harvests. So I hope that clears that up for you guys. It is not a harvester in the normal sense. You're not going to get grain out of it or corn or potatoes or canola. You are going to get the husks from the shell. So even with the corn, it's just going to husk the corn and throw the corn out. So you're not going to get any yield from it. But there's a way to work around that, and I'm going to show you that. All right, pulling in the dealership here. And so how we work around that? Well, first of all, we're going to look at the different attachments. This is the first attachment. This is the most, what I would call, destructive. Basically, this is a mower. It will cut grass. It'll cut wheat, barley, and canola, and it'll turn them into chaff. So you lose any yield except for the chaff from the field. So if I run this up and down over here on the barley or the wheat, and we'll demonstrate it, you're going to lose it. It's gone, okay? And that's what this is designed to do. This second one, I think this is the most efficient of all three heads. Even though it's little, what this is a pickup unit. And so what you're going to do is you're going to take a normal harvester, you're going to run it down your wheat field or your barley field. You're going to enable the straw swath. So as this harvester moves down the field, it's going to leave a trail behind it of straw. Okay. You then go after it with the Krone and this attachment, and you're going to vacuum up that straw swath, and you're going to get your chaff from that. So not only do you get a large yield from the crop, but you're also going to get yield from your Easy Flow 300. So you're going to double it. You're going to get the crop and you're going to get chaff. To me, that's the best setup for that. Okay. Last but not least, you have the corn header. Now, some people say this is the most efficient one out of the three, but I really think that in the long run, this is the best one because you get not only your crop, but you also get the chaff. This one turns corn husks into chaff. So we're going to run all three of these so you can see how they work. I've heard tale online that the Kramp, this is the big body, I think is what they call this. It says Kipper on the side, but it's the big body. This is the largest trailer that the Krone can use. And they said it's a little ungainly. I haven't tried it yet. I actually use two of these Agriliner tippers, and I just trailer them. And it can hit both of them. You can't do doubles with this one, though. So this is the Bandit. It can use this one, but then it can also use this one. On a side note, this is the trailer for the X-Disc, which is your mowing attachment. And this is a neat idea. The only problem that I have with this is that if you're going to pull a trailer, well, unless you have a trailer that has an extra hitch on it, this becomes useless because now you're going to have to add a tractor. I don't think the big body has... Oh, no, it does have a trailer hitch. So you know what? You could double trailer. You could run that and then hitch this behind and drag that along with you. Personally, since I'm really... I don't know. I mean, I guess I like this trailer, though. I will say that, even though I'm kind of waffling on whether you need it or not. It has this nice... See this guide here? The other trailers don't have that. So you basically run your Krone, and we'll do a demo of it when I go to move this. So we'll hook it all up and make it pretty. But let's start with the corn. Now, one of the other downsides, unlike other harvesters too, and I just wanted to point this out because I'm sure most people don't think about it, but because this is a forager or mower style, there is no harvest or autopilot. Now, look at this. I'm having an issue getting this guy hooked up. I wonder if it's too big. Well, that's what we're here for. I wanted to test this out, and it looks like it's a failure. So let's try the next one down and see if we can't get an idea of which trailer this is actually going to take. Because, yeah, it's too low. You're too low. Nope, on this one too. This is a smaller bandit, and I also tried the bigger aggro liner. Let's look in the store here so I can show you what I'm talking about. So neither of these work either. So really, you're limited to either the Flegel, the Bull, or two aggro liner HKD 302 model. So you can actually carry more if you do two of these, because this is only 32,000, but this would be a combined total of 42,000. So this is the best setup right here, is doing two of these. I'm going to get that set up for us, and we will join back in a second. Handling is not one of the Krone BiG X's, oh my gosh, strong points. First of all, because of the rear wheel steering, like all the harvesters, it's a little bit difficult to manage. Now, I think all the harvesters do this too, but it's really easy to slide this thing out, like whoops, and then the regain control is there's a lot of complaints about it, but then again, you're taking a huge piece of equipment and going a lot faster than you're really supposed to, so how much of it is our fault, how much of it is their fault? And now you can see here, this will actually fill up both, I believe, at least it did before when I tried it. Open this up. And while it's doing that, I'm going to fold the body back down again. See if I can get that to look a little bit more friendly towards our trailers. Well, we'll see what happens. You're supposed to be able to fill these all the way up, both of them. So I don't know that we'll get enough product here, but... So here's the corn header. Nice and wide. We're chopping it up. Yeah, it fills up fast. Look at that. The good news is the trailers are only showing half full, so hopefully we'll get the full capacity of the trailers. This is why they say this is the most efficient way. You can see how quickly we're filling this up. We are already, the front trailer's already halfway full. I mean, that's you know, incredible, and I've only gone a couple feet. I'm really not even into the field yet. Fill up both these trailers before we get. So here's a test, you know. This is cool. Look at how it sucks into the. So this thing just eats the whole thing, you know. This will be a good way to compare it, though. But we can see how this does versus running the harvester and following behind it. If we get in one sweep, if we get a whole, you know, trailer full. Whoops, bad driving. Very bad. So there's our nice silage, and we have gone over 50%, so that means that we are now squirting to the back. Look at that. There it is. It's flying over out the top, and you can see the attitude of the spray nozzle has changed, so it's now aiming to that back trailer. And I haven't even gotten one row of corn done yet, and I'm going to be full. So that is very efficient. Now, of course, it's a wider swath, but that's pretty cool. So we'll pick up, well, in a second here. Yeah. So this works really well. I'm impressed. Actually, this is really the first time I've used the corn header, and definitely worth purchasing. You know, now once again, though, you lose your crop of corn, so you're not getting any corn out of this. But, you know, potentially you could grow a field of corn, run a regular harvester on one half and run this on the other half, and then, you know, however much yield you get, you'll get the corn and you'll get the chaff. There we go. Now, you'll notice one thing here, okay? My trailers are full. But I'm still eating up the corn, okay? So you got to be careful. You got to watch when you fill up all the way. It's going to keep going, and you're going to lose out on all that crop. So make sure you stop and keep an eye on what's going on down in the bottom right-hand corner, because you don't want to waste all of your you don't want to waste all your corn thinking you're cutting stuff and you're not cutting anything. So let's go ahead and gonna drive this over. So that worked really well. I didn't even get a whole row done, and I filled up 40,000 units of silage. So that's or of chaff. That's going to be really useful, guys. I mean, that is a big plus for making money. So don't forget, this is all about making money. It's not about a normal harvester. This is a different beast altogether. Now, there are some other modified, or I guess what's the word I'm looking for? There are other available units that do the same thing from the mod community. So they don't, you know, but they're you have to download them, and of course you have to go through all those crappy websites, which we're going to work on that in a little bit. We'll, so you run your tipper, you tip your grass into the silo, and I think by the time we're done doing this review, we should have enough silo or enough grass to actually close the top over, so you can see what it looks like when it's blanketed, and that really will cover all the steps. So there's all that. We're empty. So we're going to run up. I'm going to take this back up and get another attachment on, and we will try the X disc next. And folks, I got to tell you, I spent a long time running some of the other equipment to mow the lawn, like doing mowing, windrowing, and then picking up with a pickup trailer. I also tried, there's a download mod for a Krone BiG L 500, which is a nice device, but you mow and you mow and you mow, and it takes forever to fill that thing up. And this is an incredible device because I just got 40,000 yield on a little bit of corn. I don't really have to work that hard to get a nice yield, and that's really going to help you make money on your farm. So even though this thing costs a ton of money, like I said, after the first two or three loads, maybe even after the first load, yeah, you think about it, if you fill that thing up all the way with a single load, if I fill that bin up to 100% and then blanket it, by that night or the next morning, I will literally have made $1 million to $2 million. So it'll pay for itself very quickly. So let's go ahead and drop this corn header off and put one right here. I've made a mess, obviously. I was crashing into stuff before. For the sake of time. Brevity. All right, so we're going to pick up our X disc. Mower header. Nice driving. Sweet. There we go. And then we're going to have to buy a harvester for our last little gig. See how we do. So here's the X disc. And I'm just going to... we're going to go over to the canola. Because the canola, out of all these crops... So once again, the X disc that I'm carrying, the 6200, it will mow grass. So if I do this, if I turn it on right now... All right, I have to go to the harvester to turn it on. There we go. I am going to start getting seed. See the seed? And it's filling up my wagons. Now, I can't really see the wagon until I do that, but let's see here. Oops. Wrong button. Oh, because I didn't load the... Oh, and you know what? I don't think I can... Oh, wait, can I do it? Let's see. Oh, there we go. Okay. And then turn this back on. So, once again, we'll start loading the buckets. Gotta put the little thing up. So there we go, we can mow grass. I can mow this canola. And we'll do a whole mow, but it, the same thing, and it doesn't matter. You don't even have to stop mowing one and go to the other. You can just go right down the path from one to the other. You don't have to switch loads or anything. This will just mow them all indiscriminately. So you just cut it down. I can run over to that weed field over there and cut that one down. I don't have to empty the trailer out. Now, we got a little head start because we did grass, but that's one of the benefits of this thing. You can pretty much cut anywhere. So, yeah, this doesn't seem like it's grabbing as much. Though it's not bad, you know, honestly, but it's definitely also not as wide of a cutter, you know. So that's going to make a difference because you've gone from, you know, 9 feet or 12 feet down to 6 feet. So you're only covering half as much area when you're mowing. So it's going to take longer using the X disc to fill this unit up. But still, it's not bad. You know, honestly, look where we're at. We're already at 22% full. So, but I think it's going to take maybe a trip and a half to fill this up all the way. So definitely not as efficient. But it's another way to do it. If you don't have any corn growing or whatever, you can just grab this and go out and mow the grass, and then mow the canola, and then you can go over here, and we're gonna just make a little nip through here because I don't want to ruin the crop for our next experiment. We'll go down to the end and do it. But you can see here I'm still getting it, so no matter what I drive on it, except for corn and of course potatoes and stuff like that, this is gonna yield some serious stuff. And so what we're going to do is I'm going to go ahead and, well, I'll catch up with you back at the end of the field here. It definitely goes up faster when I'm cutting the canola versus the grass. So the canola is giving me more of a yield than the grass is. And that makes sense, because here's a crop that you planted versus a free crop, so you should make more. I mean, we're almost up to 50%, so that's, you know, it's not bad. Like I said, it's not as good as the corn one, but this is pretty dang good. Alright, so we're going to make a turn here, and we're going to cut across the ends of these crops so you can just see how it works. Just right over. Bzzz. No problems whatsoever. Just eats it right up. So that was, I think, barley. And over here is wheat. Or maybe the vice versa. This might be barley. Yep. So I'm just going to finish running this up. I'm going to go down to the end of the field here and dump this off. And as you can see here, then we're up to almost 70% already. So this is very quickly fills up the mower. Now we're not going to get anything here because I'm on pavement. Once I get over here, you can mow anywhere you want. I'm going to mow the grass. All right, guys. So I will catch you on the other side. I'm going to go dump this trailer out in the silo, and then we'll pick up the last attachment, and we'll run it behind the harvester and see how we do as far as our yield goes. And then I'll show you how to close the silo up so that you can actually turn that grass or that chaff into silage. All right, catch you in a minute. All right, so for this experiment, we're going to run our 45-foot header on our New Holland 1090. And the idea behind using the largest harvester with the largest header is if you're using a little harvester, it's going to leave a lot of straw, and it's going to have to be windrowed. Now, using the larger harvester, you're not going to have to windrow anything because this collects 45 feet. It's about as wide as the largest windrower, so it's going to leave us a straw swath that is as fruitful as windrowing a bunch of rows together. So you only have to do, you know, this is probably the easiest one to work with. Oh my gosh. Having difficulty speaking tonight. Either this one will work or the case. Both this one, the 1090, and the largest case, I think it's the 9130. The same, it has the treads. It's almost the exact same model as this. It's just the case version. I know they're two different brands. Okay, someone's going to start a flame war over that. But it's basically the same harvester with a little less capacity in the chamber. It also has the exact same 45-foot draper, so you could use either this one or that one. These are the recommended ones. So what you need to do is you need to enable your straw swath, and you're going to do that by pressing the comma key. And so it was already enabled on mine, but and then you can hire your worker, send him to work, and he's going to go ahead and you'll see he's going to leave a trail back here once he gets going. And then while he's doing his work, I can hop into my Krone. And I can turn it on. Oh, it unfolds. Huh. I didn't know that. Really? That was the unfolding? The big unfolding? Okay, well, there we go. So now we're turning it on. Now, unfortunately, it seems like it moves a lot faster than the harvester, so look at how fast that picks up. Now, unfortunately, looks like my predictions were not true, though we'll see when we get down to the end of the field. Maybe it's too early to tell. But it seems like it's not going to pick up as much as the corn header, and obviously, with all of this heavy equipment on the field, I'm having some graphical frame rate issues. Ever since patch 1.2, man, I wasn't having issues before if I had my headlights off, but once they put that patch out, then I started having some weird, kind of irritating issues. I'm going to set my cruise control for, let's see, 11 miles an hour, slow enough to be behind them. Nope. He's going pretty slow. 8? Nope. Oh, you know what? 6. Yeah, duh. So we just follow along and suck up his swath. So this is, I don't want to say it's the most efficient way, but I think it's the most cost-effective way because that harvester is going to get filled up. And so he's going to have wheat to give to, you know, to put on my farm. And I'm going to get filled up, and I'm going to have chaff to put down. Now, we're 50% already, and we haven't done the whole field. So this is pretty efficient. Is it as efficient as the corn on its own? No, but it's still pretty good. That's not bad. And like I said, then you still get the benefit of having, you know, all the wheat that's in the harvester. So unfortunately, my harvester is going to fill up. I probably need to empty that guy out so we can get a true test of where this ended and where the corn ended. So once again, I think with the corn, we were already, we can even run over there and see if we ran this far when he fills up all the way. So I'll, you know, catch up with you in a second here. I'm going to grab Kipper. His name is Kipper. Kipper the Tipper. Come on. Nice driving. Nice driving there, bub. So we're going to empty the... We're going to carry on in this row and see... I'm willing to bet that you're going to get more from the corn. But still, like I said, I'm also getting my harvest. When I do the corn, I lose all the corn. I just get chaff. But in this case, I'm not only getting chaff, I'm also getting, you know, the seeds so that I can make money off of that end of it too. So I like the idea, I think, better of the easy flow. Now, because the harvester travels faster with the easy flow, it might be a better idea instead of following behind, though it's kind of fun to do that too. It might be a good idea to just do it after the harvester is done. So let's unload this guy and we'll catch up in a minute here. But you can see on the cornfield over there, I didn't get this far, I don't think. I think I was full before I got this far, so we'll run over there and check it out once this guy advances. This trailer is funny because it wiggles. All right, we'll catch up with it in a minute. Oh, yeah, and in patch 1.2, they did not fix the harvester sliding forward. Not as bad as it was, but it's definitely moving forward. Oh, well, what are you going to do? So on a comparison, this is where we ended. This is where we were 100% full with the corn. And you can see over there in the distance where the crone is, and that's only 70% full. So this corn is definitely more efficient time-wise, but once again, you're losing the crop. Here, I've got, you know, 50,000 of chaff or 70,000. No, 56. Wait, no. Scratch that. 20-some, 30-some of chaff and 14,000 grain. And so I'm getting a double yield from that. So I think this is definitely still the most overall efficient way to do it. But if you're looking just to get chaff, well, then grow corn and use the corn header. But if you want to get a crop and, you know, collect chaff, well, then you're better off doing it this way. So anyway, I hope that this review and we still have to cover that. But I hope that this was enlightening for you, and that you found it helpful to understand what the crone is, that it's not a normal harvester, but that it is a money maker for sure. Even though it costs a ton of money to invest in it, like I said, you do this for one field this size. If you do like this giant field that we have here, what is this number 15 or 16 or whatever, and then you go back and you do it and you do one time through corn or whatever you choose to plant here, it really will only take one run over this field to recoup the amount of money that you spent on the unit. You're going to make so much money with this thing. Okay, so here we're about to hit 100% full. There we go, we're full now. So we need to stop and let's go empty this out. And that's what this game is about, right? There's so many different ways to make money in this game, and this is just one of them. So we're going to go ahead and I'm going to fill this up and we'll see how much we have altogether. I know we have four loads at 42,000 a load. So that's going to put us at 128 should be about roughly 128,000 kilograms or tons or however they're measuring it once I'm all done. Yeah, 84,000 right now. So. All right, so you'll notice here there's a compaction number. See that compacting? If I fill it up with grass and I don't roll on this, it's not going to be able to be blanketed. And that's one of the things with silage. So what we're going to do is we're going to park these trailers and we're going to come back up here. And we're going to have to, before we can blanket it, we're going to have to compact it. And the way you do that is by driving over it. So once you have all your stuff together, or all the, you know, now for me personally, I usually fill these up most of the way before I do this, but just so I can show you how to do it, I'm going to run this over. You can see the compaction. Now it's 100% compacted, and now you can see up there on the menu on the upper left, shows 100% compacted, and it says we can blanket the silo now. So I can do it with the tractor on. If you want to play more realistically, you can jump out. and you can get on here and press R, and you're going to watch. Whoop. Okay, so now this is covered, and it shows you when you stand near it, it's going to show you a fermentation percent. We're at 1% right now. It's going to take, I would say probably when the sun is setting, so maybe around 7 or 8 o'clock at night, this is going to be fermented, and it's going to be ready to dump into those Flegal bins. And right here we have, oh, how many tons was in here? I don't remember. No, well, 126. So that is enough to generate on regular mode, like normal mode, you're probably going to generate about 1,000,002. If you're playing on easy mode, that might be closer to $2 million. It's, am I thinking that right? Maybe I'm not thinking that right. Maybe it's 600,000. Anyway, you're going to make a ton of money. And within a day or two of doing this, or maybe like one more or two more loads, this thing is going to totally pay for itself along with all of its attachments and trailers. So it's completely worth it. I know from the outset, you're like, what the heck is it? But now that you've seen it work and what it does, I think this is probably one of the best money makers in the game. This thing is going to make you rich doing the silage. So there you go, guys. Hope you enjoyed this. And once again, if you have any comments, please leave them below, or questions. I'd be glad to answer them. And we're going to go ahead and continue this series of tutorials. And I hope that you have a great night. Oh, yeah. Be sure to subscribe.